This is an example where both chemical equilibrium and phase equilibrium are present. We're looking at a reaction of A decomposing to B and C at 100 degrees C, and we know the equilibrium constant, 2.0. Keep in mind equilibrium constants are dimensionless. In this case, the standard states that were used to calculate the equilibrium constants are the pure liquids at 100 degrees C. Now, at equilibrium, we're going to have both liquid and gas present. And then to further simplify, as it turns out, the system, we'll assume that liquid B does not mix with liquids A and C, but liquids A and C mix together to form an ideal solution. We're also given the saturation pressures, the pure components A, B, and C. And so we're going to apply both chemical equilibrium and phase equilibrium, and the objective is determine the equilibrium pressure and then the compositions of the liquid and the vapor phases. So the reaction that the equilibrium constant applies to is the liquid phase reaction. Remember, the standard states are for the pure liquids. So the equilibrium constant is the ratio of the thermodynamic activity. So the activity of B, the activity of C divided by the activity of A. And this is 2.0. Activities are dimensionless, equilibrium constant is dimensionless. Because liquid B does not mix with A and C, that means we have pure B liquid present. And of course, then its activity in this problem is 1, because the standard state, right, this is fugacity of B over fugacity of pure B at the same temperature and 1 bar pressure. Well, the fugacity of pure B divided by fugacity of pure B at the same temperature is very close to 1. Because we consume ideal solution for A and C, that means the activity of A is going to be the mole fraction of A, and the activity of C will be the mole fraction of C, which is 1 minus the mole fraction of A, because B is in a different phase. It's in a liquid phase, but it does not mix. So there's only 2 components in the liquid phase. So we should be able to now substitute back into the equation. We have equilibrium constant and we have the activity. Right, the equilibrium constant, which is 2.0, is the activity of B, 1. Activity of C, which is 1 minus the mole fraction liquid phase of A, and the activity of A is the mole fraction of A. So now we have a simple equation that we can solve for XA. It's just algebra. XA is 1/3, and therefore 1 minus XA, which is XC, is 2/3. So this gives us the liquid phase composition plus pure component B. So that's the one part of the problem. The other is determining the saturation or the total pressure of the system. So we can apply Raoult's law, which is mole fraction of A times the total pressure. That's the partial pressure of A equal to XA times saturation pressure. So this is 0.333, saturation pressure 5.0 bar. So that means the partial pressure of A is 1.67 bar. The same idea holds for C. Pressure C is the mole fraction of liquid phase times the saturation pressure C. This is just Raoult's law. Mole fraction is 2/3. Saturation pressure C is 2.0 bar. And so the partial pressure C then is 1.33 bar. The pressure, the gas phase of B, is going to be the saturation pressure, because B is pure liquid, does not mix with the other liquids, exerts its own vapor pressure, and that's 20 bar. So my total pressure in the system is the pressure of A plus the pressure of B plus the pressure C. So 1.67 plus 20 plus 1.33. These are all pressures in bar. Total pressure then is 23 bar. And then the final thing is to calculate what's the mole fraction species. So the mole fraction of A is the partial pressure of A over the total pressure. So 1.67 over 23. And likewise, mole fraction of B is 20 over 23. And the mole fraction of C is 1.33 over 23. So now we've determined gas phase compositions, the liquid phase compositions, and the pressure. We've used both chemical equilibrium and phase equilibrium to do this calculation.